NIAID asked Dr. Taubenberger why he studies 1918 influenza.
You know, I think that a lot of people assume that studying the 1918 flu is just sort of a question of historical curiosity, you know, that we're just scholars and we're just interested in some remote thing that happened 100 years ago and it doesn't really have any impact on the current time or the present. And certainly studying what happened in 1918 is of immense importance from a historical and a sociological standpoint. A pandemic of this magnitude that impacted everything on Earth certainly affected all field of human endeavor, and it's worth studying. But for me, as a physician, the important thing is what can we learn about what happened in the past to try to apply that knowledge to how can we prevent something like this from ever happening again. So that's really what drives me. I guess many people who have asked me questions about it also assume that after 20 years of working on this and having the sequence of the virus for over a dozen years, that we should have all the answers by now. You know, why is it that there's no simple answer? How come I can't just point my finger to one mutation on one of the genes of the virus and say, aha, this is why it was such a killer flu? And the answer is that biology is just really amazingly complex, and it's really humbling that so much work and so much scholarship over 100 years by so many people, laboratories and epidemiologists and others, still have not answered all the questions. And it's, in a sense, disheartening, but also it's the same thing that drives me every day. A virus that only has 10 genes with only 13,000 bases can cause so much disaster to humans. Here we have a genome with 3 billion bases and we make 50,000 genes. And this simple little virus, we still don't actually understand how it works. We don't understand what all the proteins do. We don't understand how they interact with each other and interact with host cells. We don't understand even the simplest questions of how the virus is packaged and transmitted. And it's, in one time, very frustrating, but it's also, you know, motivating for me and many other people to want to get in the lab and tackle this problem every single day to try to help public health.